Hey guys, it's Alex.
And Aaron.
And today we are doing drinking coffee with us, but I don't know what you guys want to call it. If you guys come up with a weird name for it, just do it.
I agreed. So what was the last thing we talked about, Alex?
Weren't you playing about Uno Dare or something?
I think we were talking about Uno Dare, yeah, and playing it, yeah.
I think so, but I'm not for sure. As usual, you guys, no one commented because we have no viewers, but that will change soon.
Very soon.
Yeah, very hopefully. Soon. So, we had, Aaron had decided to bring a class today.
Yeah.
He broke his mic stand. And you know, these things are glass. They're glass cups put together. So we're going to be doing, maybe you'll have some fun, but.
Yeah, so that's why I don't have a mic stand, because I'm afraid I'm going to break another one.
Like usual. So, what are we going to do? What should we talk about? I don't know what to talk about. Let me see your phone. Because I don't know what we're going to talk about. If you guys need to really, the guys that come on, you guys need to comment, please.
Give us anything to talk about.
Because it's so hard when we're videotaping and all this stuff, and we have nothing to talk about. We're looking at our phone like, hey guys, come on.
My phone's stingy.
Being stupid.
Let me see it. I got it.
You don't got this.
I think it's time for me to get a new phone, guys.
Yeah, it's a pile of junk sometimes.
It is.
Maybe you should take the case off it sometimes.
No, because the screen's cracked too.
We should just, what we should do? We should just fucking blow it up.
I will when I get a new phone.
Just blow it away.
Maybe that'll be a video in the future.
Yeah, that's definitely going to be a picture. Okay, so you guys home working.
Finally. Took me only 20 minutes. Google?
What's trendy? Oh, okay, so you guys know. I'm not saying that our people in this nation need to grow up, but they do. They really do.
Some of them do.
Some of them do. Really do. Because, if you guys don't know, President Trump was inaugurated to his presidency.
Friday. Was it Friday?
No, Monday. You know what? Don't quote him on this, but we think it's Monday or Friday. Any of those days. But, you gotta understand. When I see stuff on TV about these guys, which are... They were supporters of Hillary, who now is just a person that is. She was one of the first women to actually go to presidency. But second of all, thing is, Trump won. You guys, you need to put your big boy pants on and say, okay, President Trump is my president. None of this. He's not my president. Stand for him. I'm on a riot. No, that stuff doesn't happen. We're America. We're one of the greatest countries in the world. And for you guys that do that, that just makes us look like a bunch of retards.
Agreed.
That's true. The reason me and Aaron do this is because we're just, we're having fun. And what's the point of having life if you're not having fun? For me, I'll wake up every morning and if I had to and do this, but Aaron's got school. He goes to school. But the thing is, you guys need to understand is, as the United States, we need to form together and stop being little bitches. And sorry about my language, but it's true. The people who are out there, the people who are, Starbucks, there's people that are destroying property and have no reason. Yeah, I understand. And, you wanted Hillary to be president. But the way that I see it, and all the people in this country other than the people who voted for Hillary, we want to change. And that's what Donald Trump is saying. Yeah, every president says something and it doesn't happen.
Yeah.
I mean, look at Obama. I'm not being racist or anything, but Obama said all the stuff. He was going to do this, do this, do this, do this. How many of those actual things happened?
Not that many.
No. And he was elected 2 terms. In both terms, I didn't vote for him. I voted for the under candidate. And for people, you know, that understand, this is the United States. We're one of the greatest countries. Exactly. We're the greatest country in the world. And for anybody else to say anything about it is no. I mean, what's your opinion on it, Aaron? I mean,
about
the whole issue of them going and basically starting a riot because their president or their politician that they had voted for did not win the election.
I just say grow up, basically. I mean, he won, yes, but doesn't mean you have to start a riot. I mean, come on. You guys are grown adults. Act like it, not act like 4-year-olds. That's basically what I think.
You know, the same reason, you know, you guys are right. They're rioting for no reason. You know, okay. Most people don't like Donald Trump because Donald Trump, he says all this stuff. But for him to downsize from a multi-million-dollar housing to live in a White House, it's only, you know what I mean? In the White House, yeah.
It has 32 bedrooms and...
Yeah, you know, and from where...
A theater, like...
You know, stuff like yeah. that. Okay? For you then to say, okay, this is how it is, this is what's going on. Okay, but show me what, you know, what did Hillary bring to the table? What I've read and everything is nothing comes up about, okay, this is how it is, this is what she's, you know, she's going to do. What Donald Trump's saying, and this is, okay, this is what exactly what he said, is that he is not going to take your guns away. Why would he take your guns away from a city? How do you say, I mean, there's cities with the highest crime rate in the country, and none of their civilians can have guns, but there's still guns. You take away guns, it's going to be guns.
Yeah.
No way. I mean, if I had a gun, and I did it one time, I'd protect myself with it. And you know why? It's because my constitutional right to have guns.
Second Amendment.
And for people, you know, for states to make it hard to do, you know what? Whatever.
And
you know what? I can get... In the state of Idaho, you don't need a concealed permit. No. Because they passed a law that says you don't have to.
You have to be, I think, 21 in order to carry it on your side. In public.
Well, you're supposed to be 21 if... You have to be 21 in the United States of America to own a handgun. To own a pistol, or to own a shotgun, rifle, any of those... You can be 18 years old and have a gun that's registered to you. And that's the way I see it. Is if they're going to make the same allegations and that's the way it's been for how many years, why should we? I mean, honestly.
Yeah. I mean. Yeah.
I mean. Not like we're a bunch of hillbillies running around with a stupid shotgun and blowing someone's house apart for no stupid reason. What we do is the way that we see it. If you guys understand, what they put in our, like, what a redneck is, and what I am and Aaron is, we're not rednecks.
We're city.
You know what? And the way I see it, we're not really, I mean, for Idaho, we're just normal people. We just want to protect our stuff. We want to come home, live our life, and not have any cancerous or anything like that.
Yeah. Just like today, yesterday, wait, today's Tuesday, huh?
Yes, today's Tuesday.
So Monday, after school got out, I was supposed to go in, after I got done bowling, because I bowl leagues. After I got done bowling, I was supposed to go and sign up for the draft. But bowling got canceled, and never went and got to sign up for the draft. But I'm going to sign up here soon.
And if you guys don't, I mean, you guys all know what the draft is. Draft is something that the government says that we need to do.
Yep.
And from my opinion,
I think
I would sign up anyway because you know what? My country, United States, is one of the greatest countries. And for us, you know what? If someone comes to enter our land and blows up one of our cities and does something like that, I'm going to be right there on the front lines with a fucking AK-47 getting ready to go into battle.
It's actually an M4.
But you know what I mean? It's an assault rifle. And for anybody to say, well, I don't want to do this. Why should I do this? It's because, you know what? You should be. There's people who give their lives for the freedoms that we have.
And just like my brother-in-law. He serves.
Okay, he's National Guard, but you know what? That is still
the Army branch.
It's still when something happens in our country, the National Guard are the first people
to show up
because that's what the National Guard is about. It doesn't matter what you think about, you know, what the military is, whatever like that. It's because of that reason. That there's some people who say, well, I don't think that America is as great as it once was. Yeah, it's because there's people out there that are saying, okay, the military is not that great. I don't like the president, so he's not my president. Basically, and what Aaron said earlier, screw the fuck up. And that's about my language. I'm sorry, but it's the truth. Whenever somebody says, okay, this is how it is, this is how it is, this is how it is. You need to say, you know what? This is the way it's always been. Why should it change? Okay, for me, okay, there's some laws, okay, I think that are stupid. And if you guys ever watched, I think the channel is Adam Ruins Everything. It's a TV show. If you guys ever watched that, have you ever seen the marijuana one? And I'm not being, you know what? Recreational use, yeah, you know what?
I agree with that.
You know, it's stuff like that stuff. And then the medical side, it pretty much cures cancer.
It slows cancer down.
Okay.
It doesn't really cure it, but it slows it down.
It slows it down, and then and kids, it gets rid of their, you know, if someone has, like, you know, trying to think of the word. If they have too much conversions, like, if they can stop moving, like, it's not nothing they can control, and it's something that it happens, you know, that's as soon, if you ever watch those videos, if you watched what happens when they get medical marijuana smeared on their feet or something like that. And it's gel or something, you know what I mean? So when it gets on the bottom of their feet, they stop doing it. I mean, they act like a normal kid.
They chill down, yeah.
And
just like, I guess, the rumor's been going around about Trump legalizing pot, but you have to be 21 in order to smoke it in Idaho or anywhere.
Well, the thing is,
just like alcohol,
because it's recreational.
Yeah.
Any state. I mean, Colorado's had it passed for how many years?
Two or three. 2 or 3, yeah.
And so, for, you know, that's how it is in Colorado.
Same with Oregon.
And in Oregon, but Colorado was one of the first states to legalize it.
It was Colorado, and then Oregon. Yeah.
And for, you know, basically, if it comes down to it and that vote gets put in line, yeah, I'm going to vote for it because it helps people out. There's people who move from a state that is not legal to a state that is medically available for their children. They pack up everything they own
And move.
And when they get over there and their kids are doing wonderful, what are they going to say? I'm glad I moved. Life is not about you by yourself. It's about who's in your, like, your family, it's about your others. Kids.
Yeah.
And I don't like seeing it when kids go through it when they, I mean, there's kids that have to go through it because their parents have not decided, you know. When they move, they're basically saying goodbye life and hello, you know.
New life,
because they want to see their kids get better. And the thing is the well-goodness of everybody who lives. My parents cared about me. Aaron's parents cared about him. I'll care for my kids. Aaron will care for his kids. And if you don't get that, then you don't know the meaning of life.
I'll do anything for my kids. Well, okay, so would you do anything if your kid had to move just for a medical use? Would you do it? Would you move?
It's 100%.
Yeah.
Because you know what? It doesn't matter how much money you have. It doesn't matter what kind of life you have. As long as your well-gooding of your kids is doing all right, then you better be. I mean, you're not a father unless you're caring for your kid. And that's the way I see it.
Yeah, just like my brother-in-law. He has a kid, and he goes and serves 9 months, I think it was. Last time he was out here, it was in about 9 months. And he went out and served. And, I mean, I'm proud of my brother-in-law. And that's the reason why I'm serving. I'm going to get ready to serve. I'm following in his footsteps. But he's a mechanic and the guard. I mean, yeah, they make good money. I just want to be on the front line battling. I mean, just like Alex said earlier. I mean, if they come over here and bomb our country, I mean, I'll be the first one in line with a gun getting ready to serve.
And the thing is, you know, any way you look at it, if right now, you know what I mean, if I'm going to protect my family, you know, I might not have a wife, I might not have a kid, but I still have parents, I still have friends, and I still have people I love. And those three groups are more important to me than, you know, anything, you know what I mean? Because if, you know, I'm at work. Say I'm at work and the draft comes back on. I'm the first one going to be at that recruiting office with a freaking AK or an AR-15 or something like that in my hand waiting for them to sign me up, because I would do that in a fucking heartbeat. And there's nothing that matters more than a person who wants to do that, and they do that.
Yeah.
And that's the truth. I mean,
I had a conversation with the kid at school 2 or 3 weeks ago. And I asked him what he thinks about the army and stuff. And he was like, dude, that's just a big waste of time. You shouldn't do that and blah, blah, blah. And I looked at him and was like, dude, they saved our country. I mean, if it wasn't for them, we would probably be under rules, like strict rules, like the Russians, like Soviet Union and stuff. They don't have very much freedom. We do. I mean, to be honest, I am glad that we have our freedom, but I feel bad and terrible for the people over in Soviet Union and stuff. I mean, yes, I'll be honest. I don't know them very well. I don't even know them at all. But, I mean, they're human beings. They're not a tool. And they should be treated like a living thing. You know what I mean, Alex?
Yeah, I know. You know what? And the thing is, okay, you guys need to understand, is we're not on anybody's side except for the American side. But the thing is, as Americans, with all this news that we're in fight with, you know, okay, this is how it is right now. If you guys don't know what the news is, and you guys haven't listened in, you guys know that basically the whole election that we just got a new president. all these guys are saying, well, this is how it is, this is... And it's all... It's because... Okay. Basically, everybody's saying that Russia is... Basically had a hand, their hand in the election. And if you don't know what that means, that means basically they were hacked into the computers, and they said, "Okay, this is we're gonna elect this guy." No, you need to understand, and this is something Aaron that we know about
because of government class. I mean, we spent like 2 weeks, 2.5 weeks on the election and about everything like that.
And you guys need to understand is the reason we have a president is because most of the people in the election voted for the candidate. It doesn't matter how many people vote in a state. As long as majority rules in that state, it will go to one candidate.
Yep.
And for you to say that, well, he's not my president, and this is how I look at it. For you to say, okay, this is how it is. My president is not Trump. No. Your president is Trump. It's just the way that you look at it. You're saying, nope, I'm not agreeing. I'm not going to say, okay, well, this is how this is. Okay? It's not like when if Hillary would have been voted for, I wouldn't have gone, hey, you know what? President Hillary, not my president, and start doing riots. No. Because that's how America works.
I'll just suck it up and be like, okay, she was elected.
That's how it is.
Congratulations for her, you know?
Yeah. You know what? In the way it looks, okay, the reason that most people vote for these guys is because that's the way they see it. California, okay, you have more people who live in the city than you do that live on the farmland. That's how you know, okay? If President Trump said, okay, well, this is how it's going to be. The people in the cities are going to get a discount.
Yeah.
You know, they're not going to have to pay so much on their dues. They're not going to have to pay so much on their housing. Trump would have won every fucking state. And that's to be the truth. It's because Trump talked to all the farmers and all the people. That's why he won Idaho. He won, you know, all the different states that he won. It was because he was talking to the farmer. He wasn't talking to the city folk. I mean, I'm not trying to sound like a fucking redneck or anything, but it's the truth. I live in a city, and the reason I voted for Trump is because Trump was talking to the people that work at blue-collar jobs. Not the people who are sitting up in their office doing nothing.
That have to work out in the sun.
The people who work out in the sun are the people that Donald Trump wanted to get. Because yeah. Those are people who decide who's going to win. Yeah, California's got a lot more electoral votes than a little state of Idaho. But you know what? Idaho, he was talking to the, you know, the farmers, all that. Or Hillary was in the city saying, this is what's happening, this is what, you know what I mean?
Talking to the city folks.
Talking to the city folks.
And not the country folks.
Okay, so you need to understand, we're not one of those people that are rednecks and they're going to say this, they're going to say this. But you need to understand, Obama, he was a good president, and I'm going to give him that. But you need to understand, there's something that I did not like about it. And with Donald Trump in office, first thing, what does he do? He takes the Obamacare and pretty much stops it and says, you guys can't do anything on it. Now, I would like to know, guys, I mean, this is from you guys to me. I want to know, in that bill, if you guys can find it, I'd like to know what in that bill or what on that thing that Donald Trump signed, because you know what? I want to be more, have more information from it. Because you know what? It affects my lives, it affects everybody who doesn't have health and care. Because I make over a certain amount, I can't qualify for Obamacare. But I don't make enough to get insurance. And I gotta be stuck with the $27 a month problem that it's every month. Until the bill gets pretty much handed away. So here you go. Give it away. That's the way I look at it.
Just like when the first year that Obama was elected president, I didn't agree with that, okay? I'm not racist. I mean, I just didn't see it out of other people's eyes. But he grew on me. I mean, 2 years afterwards, I was like, you know, yeah, he does good.
Okay, but the thing, Obama, and you know what? Obama was a good president. You know, he said some stuff, you know what, I didn't agree with. But you know what, he was still our president.
Yeah,
there's nothing that can change that.
Yeah.
It's just like Donald Trump. I didn't bitch and moan. Why should the people who voted for Hillary bitch and moan? I voted for freaking Nick Romney when he was elected. I voted for him, but you know what? So did the state of Idaho, because the majority ruled that Nick Romney, but Nick Romney didn't win. So I took it in like a man, not like a pussy. Not like anybody who doesn't care, or nobody who is. I mean, so does the state of Idaho. Yeah, we bitched and moaned, you know, this is not what we wanted, but you know what? Yeah. We didn't go out and terrorize our country, because you know what? That's not the way Americans work.
We just braced him, like, okay, we could work with that. Just like, I haven't voted for the last 2 years because I wasn't 18. But next time, election comes up, I'm gonna vote. Because just remember, guys, every vote counts.
Yeah, and for someone needy, okay, it's one of those things where you're kind of, yeah, I don't think I'm gonna vote, but you know what? You need to vote, because you know what? It might not matter, but at least you had. If it came down to 90 in one state, and one person did not, or 99, it came down to 99 and one person didn't vote, then you could have, like, oh, well, we don't know where to separate these votes, we separated across, and then what happens? You know what I mean?
Yeah. Just like, I knew a couple people who was 18, there's like, no, I'm not done vote because I don't like any of them. I was like, dude, just vote. Every vote counts. And they're like, you know, you're right. And they went out and voted. He didn't like any of them. Any of the candidates, really.
Yeah.
And you know what? He still voted. I didn't even know what he voted for because he wouldn't tell me. Because he was afraid that I would get mad at him.
Thing is you got to understand, he'll, you know what? And any way you look at it, the state's going to be Republican or Democratic. Because, yeah. You know what? It just depends on the state you're in. You know, yeah, there might be like 32 votes that go to California. But you know what? Thing is that you got to understand that all the votes that they get go to one cause. It doesn't just go to... If the state was like 75-25, and, you know, 3/4 of those go to one side, and the other quarter goes to the other side, it'd be a different story. But the states, the way they are, whoever has the most votes get all the votes from the state. If it was a different way where it was like 25, you know, like the way I said before, then we would have mixed results. because, you know, not every single state is going to say, you know, I want Donald Trump, but there's still that 10% that wants, okay, one of the votes goes to Hillary because that's the way it needs to be. No, it's been this way for how many years? Since the beginning of our you know,
since they started presidents, yeah, the presidency.
And you guys, you remember, it's, you know, all these states, California included, they weren't even states at the very beginning. Now that they're states, they think that they should get more. Because the state of California was just a territory at one time. And when most people moved there, it became a state. But you got to remember, every state, I think, in my opinion, should get the same amount of votes. Because, you know what? It doesn't matter how many votes you got. It's about how many states actually voted for who. And that's the way it needs to be. So, I mean, we should get on a different topic, but okay, if so you want to, I mean,
I found a good topic on the Google Trends, okay? It's the oil pipeline in Keystone, I think it was?
Yeah.
That they wanted to put it under the natives'
water supply. This is what I got for you guys. Let me see it real quick. So, basically, we're talking about the energy pipeline. It's been going on long enough. And I'm kind of mixed on the idea of it because I have a part of Native American enemy that I want to say this, okay? Basically, Native Americans, they were here before everybody else. Doesn't matter where they're from. They should have more rights than we do.
Yeah.
And that's supposed to be politically correct. But the thing is in the United States, we moved into a city, or we moved into a state, and we basically pushed everybody, all the natives out.
Yeah.
Of their original grounds.
Their homes, their grounds, and put them into one big circle so they all had to live together. And most of them didn't like it.
Oh, yeah. But the thing is, you guys gotta understand, we're all immigrants. It doesn't matter where we're from. You know, his family's from Ireland, Germany, stuff like that. I'm from, you know, I have a couple parts actual Native Americans.
So do I.
And then I have some people from out. But you gotta think, we need to loosen our grasp on the territories. Because an Indian reservation is not just an Indian reservation. Basically, America's, they like, you know, we spend money, we spend stuff like that. And for us to say, okay, Native Americans, you need to be in this country. And right, okay, if this cup was one of the things, this is this is the Indian reservation. Everything on the outside is America. And you gotta remember, all this stuff used to be Indian. And for them, for all these people to go into one small circle in the country
without knowing any other ones.
Exactly. You know,
it was hard for them. I mean, I knew someone who was a Cherokee Indian. I mean, and they didn't like the idea of putting them all into one area. I meant, like, they should have multiple Indian reservations for the Pacific Indians. Like, for the Cherokees and other ones, you know?
Okay, so get back on the topic. Okay, you need to understand. America, Indian reservation. There's a line. And for them, okay, basically, the Indian reservation is going to be separated again. Because it went from this big to this big. Now it's going to be cut in half with a big pipeline in the middle of it. You know what I mean?
Yeah, through their water supply. And And they stood up and fought, and then more people from like all over different countries came and stand with the Indian for the Indians. And I guess the pipeline got hold to make sure, you know, they thought it through more. And I guess they were like, well, yeah, I can understand why they stopped.
And you guys need to understand is the way we look at our country now. And the way that we look at it back when, the people that started our country, like George Washington, Samuel Adams, all those people, they said, this is how it's going to be, you know what I mean? And for us to say, okay, this is how it is now, it's a whole nother ball field. And what I mean by ball field is, basically, if you made a ball field in the thing where they stood, we're like 16 from where George Washington were sitting. And say that's baseball. This is baseball terms, okay? George Washington's here. Here's the field. We're like six different fields away from here, but we're still America. If we were to go back to our roots as America, we'd be, not only if George Washington seen us now, but seen us back then, he'd be like, he'd be kicking our ass. You know what I mean? And it's the truth, because back then, all they cared about was family and stuff like that. Yeah. Now it's about politicians and about how it is. So, that's the way I see it. Let's get on to another subject while we're ahead, guys.
Let's see.
And why Aaron does, I'm going to get coffee. So,
can you fill me up too, please?
Yeah, I can.
Alright, just...
Oh, man.
Just milk, please.
Just milk? Okay.
Yeah.
Somehow I didn't break that, but Aaron did earlier, so...
I don't know how. I didn't even touch it. I probably mind used. Alright, so, yeah. So, like, we were doing the bot... We were doing the, here, I'll tell you which one we were doing. We were doing the, where was it? Keystone Pipeline, Donald Trump Keystone Pipeline, and I was a big against it, but I'm glad they stopped it. So we're probably gonna do I don't know what we should do. There's to be honest, we don't change subject from politician and like presidency. See, I'm gonna talk about football. I'm a huge football fan, and I think that the Super Bowl coming up, I don't know when it is, this is gonna be a really good Super Bowl. And my cousin a couple weeks ago asked me, who do I think is going to go to the Super Bowl? And I told him the Falcons and I think it was the Falcons, or it might have been the Chiefs. Either the Chiefs or the Falcons and Green Bay. Yes. I'm a huge Green Bay fan, so, yeah. There's Overwatch. Okay. I found a good one. Academy Awards. Deadpool Ryan Reigns, I think. If you guys didn't know, there's a second Deadpool coming out a couple years. 2 years, I think. Either it's next year or the year after that. But I love Deadpool. The first one was a good movie. I knew they were going to make a second one. Yeah. Yeah. So, I picked, for Deadpool. See? Yeah. I picked this one. The Academy of Worlds.
So, if you guys know what I mean, he's basically gone over. What have you been gone over? I mean,
basically, I just told him that it was a good movie, that there's a second one coming out, and yeah, that's it, basically, so far.
So, who do you think is going to be in the second one?
Second one? I'm pretty sure that they're going to keep the person who's playing Deadpool in the first one the same. And I'm pretty sure they're going to probably show Wolverine in the second one, because he was always talking about Wolverine in the first one. And it showed the mansion, what is that mansion called?
You know what? I don't remember, but...
Yeah, neither do I, but they showed that and a bunch of them. Talked about the Storm, I think that's her name. Yeah, talked about a lot of them. And, yeah. If you guys haven't seen the first Deadpool, I suggest watching it. It's a really good movie. Yeah. Good action movie. I watched it, me and Alex here and my brother went and watched it in the theaters in D-Box, right?
Yeah. Basically, if you don't know what D-Box are, we have only in, I guess, everybody else has them, but our Twin Falls Cinema does not, only has them in the new one. So what happened was, we were watching the movie, and these seats go up and down. And I've never sat in them.
Like, you're actually in the movie with, like, cars, the jumping off, the flipping. It moves. It's really cool. I liked it. And, it was fun. I would watch any movie in D-Box seat. But it just cost, like, an extra, $6?
Yeah. It was... From what I remember, it was $18 altogether for one seat. And we had four people. And
three
I ended
people.
Up, yeah, I thought we had Shane with us.
No, Shane couldn't come because he was working.
Oh, that's right. So we only had three of them. And so I think it was like almost like 56 or something. Mm-hmm. It was actually 54, I think. Pretty sure it was 54.
Let's find out. So, calculator. So it was 18 times 3? Or?
Yeah, 18 times 3. So it was about 54.
54, it was like 50.
56 with tax.
Yeah. Well, 55 plus tax. Yeah. Round it up.
Okay, so we're going to, you know what? Let's get off of topics. Let's play a game. Last time we played Uno, now today we're going to play Uno.
We need a towel to dry that off. I'm not sure.
Go ahead and see if they're coming back there.
Alright. I'll be back. Maybe.
Just take it with you.
Yeah. I'm just going to take it with you.
Just disconnect it. And if you guys missed our last episode, please sign up for it. Because last episode we had kind of some fun. I think there's some paper towels right there.
Ooh. Got my head in. That
works. Okay. Let's see how that works. So basically what happened earlier is we dropped inside.
We spilled some
coffee.
Yeah, coffee.
So if you guys don't know what Uno Dare is, it's Uno Dare. Basically you pick up a wild card or a plus two card and it's Dare.
And it has rules on it.
I think I hit the other one in here. Hold on.
I have two of the
The rules.
Well, we only have one.
Yeah. So basically, there's dares on these cards, and you have to do them if you get the number. So we're going to do.
And some of the ones we can't do because we're not flexible. So we will only draw two. I just want to play Uno. Can we just play Uno?
No, for playing Uno Dare.
Just one game of Uno. Come on.
Uno Dare.
No.
Come on.
Then after this game, I want to play one
it's
game of
six,
Uno.
It's six, right? Or seven?
It's either
six or seven.
Seven, but I usually do... seven. I usually do six. Or ten.
Okay.
Because I like a longer game. But sometimes I get really good cards, and it just does...
How many cards you got now?
Just doesn't last long.
Lost count.
Four right there. I have eight.
I have seven. Let's go.
Alright, so yeah, like... We doing 10?
Yeah.
9. I need one more.
You got 10. I just handed you 2.
Okay, I'll recount. Hold up, guys.
Aaron's really slow at counting.
I am just not in it today.
Not today. Not. Not ever.
Okay, my bad. I miscounted, okay? Don't fire me.
Fire you! I'll just make you take out the garbage.
I do that too much at my house, so... we need a first card?
Yeah.
And it is a red 5!
Red 5. That's a yellow 5.
My bad. I haven't got much sleep.
I'll go first. Go.
I've been up way too long.
Hurry up. Quit sleeping. Skip. Skip.
Too many damn skips. I'm not doing any dares.
Skip.
God, how many skips do you got? You cheated.
No, I didn't.
Yes, you did. You had to.
6.
God, about damn time.
About damn time. I should have used the other one. God dang it.
Should have, would have, could have.
Yeah,
but
shut
you didn't.
Up. Stupid.
Okay, let's see if I can pull this off. Of course, he has like, I don't know how many. I only have 9 cards now. He has like 6. So let's see.
5.
Skip. And.
Notes.
Let's go.
Yachty.
Let's go 5. Why not?
7.
1.
4.
1. Someone gets stuck.
Green.
And you can go and buy in a hole.
And where's the cards? Where's the dare cards? I got
right here.
Let me see them. Let me see ya.
On the green ones.
Yep.
They don't have. They're the house rules, which you can make your own and then write them on there. But with us, we just pick off the other ones. What is it?
So basically, guys, if you guys don't understand, we pick each other's what they're going to do. So the green, you can do any card because there's only 4 cards. The green has
3
nothing,
cards, actually.
Yeah, well, there's 4 cards, but the green has nothing on it.
It's a house card.
It's called a house card. So we basically said for every green card, we're going to do one of the 3 other cards. There's show off, Daredevil, and Family. And this one, this is the one I picked. It's number 1 for green. It is Act Like a Dog.
Okay. Hey, can I say something though? Nice 6.
Nice 6.
Alright, rough.
8. Rough.
Just straight up. Just no. You know what? You know
reverse,
what?
Reverse. And you pick a card.
Okay, your turn.
Uno and.
Wait, can we just play one round of Uno?
Yeah, we can.
Alright, sweet.
I'm
dealing though.
I thought the Uno card or Uno there was a little bit better.
Yeah, I like regular Uno.
Yeah.
There's also another Uno that I really like. It's called Uno Spin. That's a good game.
Yeah, it's pretty good.
So we're doing 10 cards, right?
Yeah.
Alright.
What would you do for a comic book?
Sure, going slow.
Hurry up! Okay, it's in.
Are you sure? Are you fucking sure? I'm positive. Sure? Are you partially afraid? What are you picking for color? No, just do it.
Let's do red.
Okay.
I go first this time because he went first last time.
Too bad for you. Too bad for Gold. Answer everything by clapping your hands.
So I said red, right? Correct.
You gotta believe in fairies, Taryn.
I don't believe in fairies. I believe in...
ghosts?
Ghosts. I believe in devil. I believe in hell, heaven, anything. But I do not believe in fairies.
Can you go, please?
You know what? Let's do it this way. Reverse 8.
5.
4.
3.
2.
Uno.
Yellow.
God damn it.
We're just playing regular Uno.
I'll play. No, I'm not doing that one. Alright, yeah, I gotta pick 2 cards. 1. Oh, got a hit. What color?
Yellow.
Yellow. It's your turn. Just so you know. Pick it up. Say 8.
3. 6, 5, 0, 9.
Reverse.
Okay, fair enough.
6. Reverse. No, getting.
My turn?
Yeah,
Uno.
Uno went off. You don't have Uno.
1.
Uno. Shut up the way. Híjole. That's the way we before.
The puns are real.
These retards.
Is that 6?
Yeah, that's a 6. Oh, great. Uno momento. Uno momento. Oh. Go.
Uno. Reverse. Oh, wait. It's my turn, too.
God damn. I win. So I gotta play 6 until the very end.
God damn. Lol.
What color was it?
I don't know. I just didn't pick. I just won.
Just pick the color.
Blue. Oh. It's my turn. And it was 6?
Yeah, it was 6.
Try to blow only 1 card off the top of the draw pile.
Nope, fell. Gotta do it again.
And fell. And...
Oh, okay. Yay! Oh, I'm sorry. I fell asleep for a minute.
Okay, your turn.
It's my turn to draw. Jackass. Yes! Okay, give me a minute. So, we are back again, sorry guys.
Back again.
Shut up. Help some home message in. You guys heard that? Okay. Now we start the game. Sorry guys, we had to leave for a second. I had to do some stuff. So we're playing Uno Dare still. 4? Why do we have 2 cards here?
Because you put 1 down.
No, I didn't.
Yes, you did.
No, I didn't.
Yes, you put that down. Count how many cards you have in your hand.
Okay. 3. Alright, yeah. Okay.
You put 1 down, I put the 3 down. Are we playing just regular Uno?
No, we're playing Dare.
Alright. Draw 2. And 6. And it's the red.
If I don't want to do it, then I don't have to. I have to draw 2, which I don't want to.
Talk like your mom or dad until your next turn.
Go feed the dog. Go take the dog out.
Skip. Reverse.
Pick up 1. Uno momento.
After this.
Reverse. Mm. Nop. Green. Let me see the cards.
I'm not doing it.
Yes, you are. You're doing it. Shut up. I did last time. 13. You've done that one before.
Can I just draw two?
I really want to see you do that one. That would be funny. Make a funny face till next turn. That's not funny. I'm not laughing yet.
Fuck you.
Oh, just to let you guys know, I can't. When people make, like, if somebody gets hurt or is, like, in pain, I laugh. But if someone tries to make a funny face, I cannot laugh for some reason.
I'm just drawing two. Watch it. One.
Uno, dos.
Two. See that?
What color did I go green? Uno.
Six. Six? How about you two or six? Shove it up your ass.
God damn it.
Oh, it's not green anymore.
Go ahead. That's it. Okay. I was supposed to say that. Okay.
Yellow. Cough the cards over.
Oh, god damn it. They're over there. Yellow.
Yellow is show off. And it's 14. Talk like a pirate until your next time.
I am matey. Stop masturbating with a toothbrush. You're right, Todd. You son of a bitch, you better play that stupid card.
The lows are real.
Go home.
I can't go.
You can't go. Ha, ha, ha.
I can.
I can't go too. Ha, ha, ha.
I can't go. Ooh. Blue.
God damn it. I was about to do that one on you.
The blues are Dill Devil, so they're the good ones.
Oh, shut up.
What is it, 7?
Yes, it's 7.
Do 10 push-ups in 10 seconds.
Not doing it.
Draw 2.
Mm-hmm.
And it's my turn.
Those ones are stuck together. Just like your mother.
That's harsh. Talk about other people's parents like that.
9. Go ahead.
I should be right now.
Red. Fuck. I told you I had to
come. Hands. With the one.
Any Uno.
What?
Baby talking to?
Nope, I don't feel like.
Okay.
I'll just draw.
I'm gonna go throw your cards in there because it's not over. Because all the cards I got are these ones. Okay. Deal it. Deal it like a tot.
Deal it like a tot. Deal it like a tot.
You know what? I think our record is 2-1, I think, right now. Ain't it?
Mm-hmm.
2-1, ain't it?
Yeah, I won.
I won 2.
You won 2. I won 1.
Yeah. Oh, my goodness. Oh, my goodness. Oh, my God. Oh, Andy. Oh. Did you hear Kat passed away?
Yes. Someone shot her in the face with a 12-gauge.
I know. And we're not kidding, guys. We had literally had a best friend that got shot in the face with a 12-gauge.
And
now he's doing almost 25 years.
Nope. He I guess he's in intensity. But if he does walk, it only sucks for him. Because he'll probably be safer in jail.
What color? Oh, my God.
It's just only blue.
Okay.
And we're just playing regular Uno this time.
I don't know. You know what? We'll still dare because that's the way the viewers like it.
I don't care. I don't want to play dare.
You know what? You're a failure to the viewers. The one viewer.
Which is you?
No. Which is you.
That was a real... My turn. I'm not playing Uno dare, so...
Oh, we're doing a dare, so don't even go there.
Reverse to me.
Guess who? Not you.
4.
3. That's the way.
I like it.
Uh-huh, uh-huh.
That's
I'm just drawing two.
Nope. You're doing this one.
I don't give it.
You're doing this one because you're doing three. You know what? Listen.
I'll draw three if I have to. I'm not doing it. Fine, here.
You've done this one before, so why don't you do it now?
I'll listen to it. What is it?
House rules, because it's green. And...
what is it?
Talk to the player on your left like they are the celebrity crush.
I'm good.
No, hold on. You have to do one of these three. And I know you'll do this one. Spin around five times, walking 10 paces in a straight line.
I'll just do that one. It'll be done fast. How many times? Spin around? How many times?
10, I would think.
Okay.
Comment if life is real at 10 per each round. I said 5. Okay. Hey, how many fingers am I holding up? No, how many fingers am I holding up? You're not even walking in a straight line.
Okay.
Now
I just did 11 turns. Screw you, it's my turn.
Hurry up. Are you going yet? You know what's funny?
You put down another card, I'm gonna punch you.
No, I didn't put down another card, but that's pretty close. Skip.
Okay.
Two.
I don't care about those. 4. Please tell me I have a 6.
No.
Sex for you.
Go.
4. The lows are real.
5.
9.
Nine.
1.
I got ya.
I'm not doing it.
Yes, you are.
Make me.
Act like a total diva, dude. I know you love this one.
No. I'm not. I'm not in the mood to. Go.
You can't pick one up. You can't put one down.
Watch.
Because you picked two up.
I don't care. I still can play it.
7.
Shit, I shouldn't have put that down. Oh, well. The rolls are real.
Go. You're gonna say green, I know you are.
How do you know?
Because your cards are real. That's the way.
We haven't done this one. And this one be red. Talk like a space alien until your next turn.
Hello. My name is Jeff. And I'm. And that's the way she likes it.
Okay, I'm just gonna say this, viewers.
God, you fucking pissed me off. 1.
By the way, oh no.
1.
1.
1.
Oh no, again. I win.
No. Ah, oh, you motherfucker.
And that's how you play poker, guys.
So now we're like 2-2, right?
2-2. No, 2-3.
So you got the shift. You got to shut the window.
Wait, why do I have to shuffle?
Because you didn't shuffle last time. Shut the way, hijo de gasoe. Por favor.
That's on your mind. You know what he is.
The LOL live. Hey. You missing some cards?
Oh, damn. My bad. What are the cards facing down over there? Destruction cards?
No. A 7 and a 4. Híjole, acaso el pendejo. Híjole.
Slacker.
Fucking beat off her.
Nope.
Oh, 1.
Ooh, that is 1. Sorry, guys, we were filling a lamp. He was filling it that way. You guys said Monday.
I got the bottle.
The hell, bruh?
Hey, the bottle, sorry. That's the way. She likes it.
In the butt.
What? What in the butt?
She does. I know someone who does.
Oh, so to let you guys know, we are coming up with a new song. It's called What in the Butt.
Well, he is. I haven't really made it much thought because I've been too busy on school.
You're going to do it.